Hi there, welcome to Scrap and Coffee. I'm going to continue with my Christmas Trifold mini album. In the last video, we've completed the first page, and now we are on to the second page. Okay, on to page number two. Again, I'm going to start with my opening for my hinge on my left side. And we've got two pieces that measure 5 1/4 by 4 3/4. Those are going to form pockets, so I'm going to minor those corners on the bottom. So scoring marks on three sides, tape on the dented side. And I'm also going to give these pieces a punch on my envelope punch board. So let's get it in again. And I'm going to punch it at 1 3/4 on both sides. 1 3/4, line it up, punch, flip it over. Again, 1 3/4, punch, and I'm going to cut away the middle piece so I don't have to make a mark. And I'm going to do that on both of the pieces. Flip it over and punch again. Then we are going to cut the middle away. So again, I'm going to line it up with that 3/8 of an inch. Place my blade in the middle of the middle piece and cut down and up to get it. Cut it out. Yeah, 3/8 of an inch. And I'm just making sure that I'm not placing it too high. And make that cut again. So then we can fold on our score line. So you see we've got a little envelope tab. See if they don't overlap. They overlap a little here. It again, that's better. Do the same on the other one. And again, they overlap just slightly, really slightly. So if I cut it away on one half, I'll be fine. Yes. Now I need to think. I'm going to place the pockets with the folded over edge on my binding side and my opening on my folded over edge. So again, I need to stay away slightly from that hinge side in order to make my pocket lay flat. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to line it up with the bottom, staying away from that cut edge here, about 1/8 of an inch. And then I'm going to turn it over for me just to make it a little easier to remove my tape backing. Just line it up with that bottom. And I'm just using my needle again. Telling you, paper crafting is not good for your nails. And then I can remove the other pieces as well. Again, just making sure I go straight on there and burnish it down. Now the other piece will go in the same direction, just next to it. And it should fit perfectly on your page. So again, I'm just going to remove one side first. I'm going to line it up here. And then remove the other two sides. Thank you. So this is what we have now, two pockets. And you can leave it just like this, but I'm going to make, again, a little closure for it. So I've cut two pieces that measure 4 1/4 by 2 1/4. And I made pencil marks, 3 1/4 up from the bottom and 1 1/4 inwards. I'm going to cut away those corners. And just to make it easy on myself, I'm going to use this piece as a template for the other one. So I'm just going to place it on top here. And I could have cut it all in once. So now I have my two pieces cut. I've made a score line at the 2 1/4 inch side at 1/2 inch, and I'm going to fold on that. The tape is on the dented side again. And I'm going to place them, lining it up with the folded over edge. And I think I'm just going to remove my tape backing here. Lining it up with the corner. That's one. Just making sure it fits. I should have minored it. I didn't minor the other one, but I'm going to do it on this one. And I'm going to line it up with the corner at the bottom. Just going to close this one real quick. And burnish it down. So this is the first side of the page. Then we are going to flip it over. Just remove my stuff a little bit here. Now the first two pieces that we are going to use is, I have a piece that measures 6 1/2 by 5 5/8 inches. And I've made a score line on the 5 5/8 at 1/2 inch. Place the tape on the dented side. And this is going to be a flap. And we are also going to make punches on this flap. But we have to be careful because we want the tab to be the same on both sides. But here we are going to fold over 1/2 inch. So on this side, without the score line, I'm going to tab at 2 inches, punch at 2 inches. And then I'm going to turn it over, and here I have my score line, and I'm going to line it up with 2 1/2 inches. And then we are going to cut away this middle piece. Lining it up with the 3/8 again. So now we have a nice even tab. So keep that in mind when you're punching and you have a score line on one side and not on the other, then you have to adjust your measurements for it. The second piece that I'm going to use measures 7 by 6 1/8 inch. And on the 6 1/8, I've scored on 1/2 inch on both sides. So that's 1/2 and 5 5/8. And on the 7 inch side, I made one score mark at 1/2. So it's going to be a pocket. I'm going to minor those corners. And again, I'm going to punch. Oh, it's right here. And here we have a score lines on both sides. So I can both punch them on the same measurement. And that will be 2 1/2. And cut away that middle piece. I'm trying to do it quick to keep the video a little bit short, but I also don't want to go too quick. So the first piece, I'm going to have my folded over tab on my right side, and I'm going to place the pocket on top of that piece. So I'm going to fold it all in line it up, and if we've done it a good job, then our tab at the top should line up. And it does. Hooray! So I think I'm going to use my nail again here. And just remove the other pieces. And this gives us a pocket on a flap. Then I have two more pieces. One measures 6 1/8 by 3 3/4. And on the 6 1/8, again, two score lines at 1/2 inch. And on the 3 3/4 on one side. So again, this is going to form a pocket. We'll minor those corners. And I have a piece that's going to be a flap. This measures 3 3/4 by 5 1/8. And on the 3 3/4, I made a score line at 1/2 inch. And I'm going to taper those that 1/2 inch. Like that. And also these pieces, we are going to use our punch board. On one side only. And on the pocket piece, so I have my 1/2 inch flaps on the sides, I'm going to place it at 2 1/2 inch. And I'm going to cut away this piece. And on my flap, no score lines on the side, I'm going to line it up at 2 inches and cut away this piece. So, get that done. So now I'm going to fold all my score lines from my pocket. And I'm going to fold on the score line for the flap as well. I'm going to lay the flap flat, and then I'm lining up my pocket with the top cut edge, and then it should fit perfectly on your flap. So again, we are going to stick that down on there. So again, we have a pocket on top of our flap. And now this flap we are going to place on our first pocket on the bottom, lining it up with the left side and the bottom. Oh, it's only taped on the bottom. Now, so we have a flap that goes down, and it's like a pouch pocket, and this flap will open up sideways. So I have my base page. This is what we've just attached. Here, the hinge will go on the left, and we will turn it over. And I'm going to place this flap on top of that base page. Again, my hinge will be placed on this side, so I'm going to line it up with the folded over edge here on my left and with the bottom. So I'm going to stay away from that hinge side again. And because there is already a lot of stuff on there, it's hard for me to see that I'm nicely lined up. And as you can see, I've stayed away from that hinge side a little bit. So now this opens up and this opens up to the bottom. Eventually I've decided to not place the flap on the bottom of the second page. So now I have, when I open it up, I have the flap here with the pouch pocket, and here I just placed the pocket. I didn't do the flap because I felt like it wasn't opening the way I wanted to open, not this way and also not down. So I've just decided to only place the pocket. If you want to place the flap underneath here, sure, that's up to you. You can totally do it. I will leave it in the cutting guide, but I just didn't use it. But instead, I'm cut a piece that measures 4 3/4 by 6 1/4. And on the 4 3/4 side, I made a score line at 1/2 inch. Place tape on the dented side, and when I'm opening this up, I'm going to place it right here on the bottom, and that will give me an extra space for 6x4 pictures or 4x4 and some pattern paper if you want to. So I'm going to place that right here on the right side, and this is a folded over edge, so I can just line it up with that edge and stick that down. And then our pages are complete. So I'm going to put some patterned paper on there, and then we can place them in our book. So now I can close it up, and that's my second page. So only the pocket here on the bottom. I've completely matted both pages, and now we can attach them into our album. So eventually I ended up using the envelope closure on this one as well. I used a magnet here, but I it's not quite strong enough, so just to be sure I did the envelope closure on that one. So this was the first page, and I'm going to attach that one on my left side. So this is the hinge that's offset, and I'm going to give it a fit. Well, if it doesn't fit, then I have a problem. But I know it fits. I've already tried it, of course, but see, that fits easily. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the tape backing out of one side of my hinges. And I'm going to slide the page on there. And it's pretty difficult because I don't have an opening here, so I'm not able to put my hand in there. And I try not to stick it down on the side that's where the tape backing is removed. I try to slide it on there, not completely to the bottom of the album. Get it straight, and stick it down, and then I turn it over and I remove the tape backing out of the other side of the hinge. And make sure it sticks as well. Give that a burnish. And you can place your pages in here before you put all your pattern paper on there, but I just find that it's easier to get things on there straight when you can just play around with it, lay it flat. When it's in your album, that's a little bit more difficult to do. So that's the first page in the album. And because when I tapered, I started tapering at where my tape starts and not completely at my score line. So that makes my page stop about 1/8 inch away from that score line. And it also makes it easier for my page to lay flat in the album. So I don't place it completely onto the cover, that will make your page stand up a little bit more. So I'm going to do the same thing with this page. Give it a fit. I know it fits, but... Okay, so I'm going to remove one side of the tape backing. And I have to apologize. I hope it doesn't... It's too much of a problem, but they've decided that today is the best day to place grass on the park that's in front of my house. But there is about 5 inches snow lying here, so they have to remove all of that snow, and they're working on it right now. So I hope it's not giving too much noise on the background. So again, I'm placing it on there, not completely down to the bottom. Try to get it straight, make it stick, and then remove the other side, the tape backing on the other side of the hinge. And with this tool, this is from Cricut, yeah, it's really easy to get this tape backing there. When you have to do that with your fingers, then you really have to struggle, at least I have to struggle. And that's the second page, and this one I've placed it a little too close to the... You see, it's standing up a little bit more, but okay. It's fine. I think it's also because of the add-on here. So our pages are in. Now we can... And it's going this way, but we are going to make some pockets on the sides and something in the middle. So we are going to work on that right now. Okay, I'm going to start on my left inside. I'm going to make sideways stack pockets, and for that I need two pieces that measure 9.5 by 2.75. On one piece I've made score lines on three sides at 1/2 inch, and on one piece I did the longer sides 1/2 inch, sorry, on the shorter sides 1/2 inch, and on the long side 3/4 inch. Well, here I made a mistake, so ignore the lowest score line. And this one we are going to minor the corners, so I'm going to do that. So the tape is on the dented side again, and on the other one I'm going to, this is the stack pocket, so I'm going to cut here up to my score line and cut it away at an angle on both sides. Making sure I have the right score line here. I'm going to fold on those. Making sure they don't overlap, it's just fine. And a little overlapping. Okay. And on this one I'm only going to fold on that 1/2 inch score lines. And I'm going to cut away these little things that are hanging there. So I'm going to place them sideways with the opening towards the side of the book. And here I always use, I've placed that piece of black cardstock in here that measured, what was it, 5.5 by 8.5, I believe. Yeah, so that is my guideline for placing my add-ons on there. So I'm going to line it up with the edges of that piece. Moving the tape backing here. And it's really hard to see that edge with the black on the black. And normally I would really get my face in there, but then you would be looking at the back of my head on camera, and I don't want to do that to you, so. Sorry, I'm out of camera. So that's the first piece. Oh, and I forgot to make my... I was going to tap these. So I am going to use my undo. If I can open it. I'm always struggling to open this bottle. It's child safe, but it's also safe for me. So this stuff, that's really a lifesaver for me, really often. It just makes you to be able to remove your piece, but when it dries, it evaporates, if I'm saying that correctly, then your stickiness will still stick. And it doesn't leave any marks on your cardstock. So I removed it. My tape is still on there, and when it dries, it will stick again. And it smells pretty strongly, but I'm that kind of crazy person that kind of enjoys that smell. So I don't mind. It's not that I'm making mistakes so that I can use it, but. Okay, I'm just trying to put the tape back on there because I need to place it in my punch board for a second. So I'm getting my punch board out here. And I didn't really decide on what I was going to do with this one. And I think because I didn't really take that in account in my score line here, that I am going to just make a notch in the middle. So my piece was 9.5, so that gives me 4.75 is the center of my piece. So that's where I'm going to line it up with. 4.75. And this wasn't completely what I had in mind for these pieces, but that's all right. This is fine as well. I did this on some other pieces as well, just a notch, so and it's not like it's totally not going with the rest of the album. So okay, let's see. This is almost dry. This is sticky again, so yeah, I can place it on there, I think. Just fold back in there. And problem fixed. And this piece, we can just slide it in there. And the score lines that I can see now here in that notch, I will cover that up with pattern paper, so that's no problem. And I have to say, this paper pack by Cartabella, the Christmas paper pack, I really love it. It's got some really nice papers in there. The only thing that I don't completely love are actually the red papers in here. Because this red, it's just a little too bright for me. And then there is another red, and that's just a little too dark, I guess. It's, I don't know, it's... doesn't feel completely right to me, but so I'm not using it a lot. I'd use it here, but on the other pieces I haven't used any red, so I guess I have to do it somewhere else, because otherwise this will look a little bit off. But so I will use it here at least. Okay, so that's the left side. Now for the right side, I have two pieces. That measures six and a one piece measures 6.5 by 3¾. This is going to be a pocket. So score lines on three sides, tape on the dented side. And one piece that measures 6.5 by 3. And I have on the 6.5 side two score marks at 1/2 inch. And here I stayed away 1 inch from the bottom. And that's because, again, we are going to punch these pieces. I'm going to line it up with the 2.5 mark on my board on both sides, and I'm going to cut away that middle piece, and I'm going to do this on both of my pieces. And 2.5. So I just want to show you quick that for my matting process, what I did is I used some scraps, and I've punched it at different sizes, like here 1 7/8, 2 1/4, 1 1/8. And when I'm going to mat these pieces, I'm just getting in my my template, and I will just see what size of punch will fit best on my mat. So that was really helpful for me to decide what size I'm going to punch my pattern paper. I just saw that lying there, so I thought I would share that with you. Now I have to get my paper trimmer. Here it is. So I'm going to cut out those middle pieces. This is the normal pocket. I'm going to minor those corners, and I still need to clean my scissors. And this will be a stack pocket. So here I'm going to cut on that 1 inch score line and cut that away at an angle. And I've made it 1 inch here on this piece because of this piece that we've cut out, and I wanted to make sure that I was low enough with my pocket. So I'm going to fold on its score lines, and we are going to place that on the right side of our album. And on this one, only folding on that 1/2 inch. Clean up that corner a little bit. That's better. I've marked my desk with a Sharpie over there. So I'm going to line it up with that piece of cardstock that I stuck on there when I made my cover. And of course, all those pencil marks from the measurements on my pieces, I can erase before I place my pattern paper on there. But that's because I don't have a cutting guide yet. I'm working on it as I go, but I wanted to make sure that you can see the measurements. So that's the first pocket, and then this one can slide in here. And again, you will be able to see that score line here, but you will cover that up with your pattern paper. so that gives us a stack pocket over here as well.